Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Saturday, Memorial of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. O God, come to my assistance. O Lord, make haste to help me. You are my rescuer, my help. O Lord, do not delay.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Grant us, O merciful God, protection in our weakness, that we who keep the memorial of the Holy Mother of God may, with the help of her intercession, rise up from our iniquities. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord is our God, the Lord alone. Therefore, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength. Take to heart these words which I enjoin on you today. Drill them into your children. Speak of them at home and abroad, whether you are busy or at rest. Bind them at your wrist as a sign and let them be as a pendant on your forehead. Write them on the doorpost of your houses and on your gates. When the Lord your God brings you into the land which he swore to your fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, that he would give you, a land with fine, large cities that you did not build, with houses full of goods of all sorts, that you did not garner, with cisterns that you did not dig, with vineyards and olive groves that you did not plant. And when therefore you eat your fill, take care not to forget the Lord, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, that place of slavery. The Lord your God shall you fear, him shall you serve, and by his name shall you swear." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I love you, Lord, my strength.
I love you, Lord, my strength.
I love you, O Lord, my strength, O Lord, my rock, my fortress, my deliverer.
I love you, Lord, my strength.
My God, my rock of refuge, my shield, the horn of my salvation, my stronghold. Praise be the Lord, I exclaim, and I am safe from my enemies.
I love you, Lord, my strength.
The Lord live, and blessed be my rock. Extolled be God, my Savior, you who gave great victories to your king and shown kindness to your anointed, to David and his posterity forever.
I love you, Lord, my strength.
Alleluia, alleluia. Our Savior Jesus Christ has destroyed death and brought life to light through the gospel. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus came up to Jesus. A man came up to Jesus, knelt down before him and said, "Lord, have pity on my son, who is a lunatic and suffers severely. Often he falls into fire and often into water. I brought him to your disciples, but they could not cure him." Jesus said in reply, "O faithless and perverse generation, how long will I be with you? How long will I endure you? Bring the boy here to me." Jesus rebuked him, and the demon came out of him, and from that hour the boy was cured. Then the disciples approached Jesus in private and said, "Why could we not drive it out?" He said to them, "Because of your little faith. Amen, I say to you, if you have faith the size of a mustard seed, you will be able to say to this mountain, 'Move from here to there,' and it will move. Nothing will be impossible for you. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Now today, let me invite you to reflect on the gift of faith, no? The first point, no? the power of faith, if you wish, no? And then the second is very much related to this, is that saying or that belief that I have, no? That we become what we believe in, no? And then second is the importance of allowing to or creating an environment that would allow us to have faith, no? So these three points to reflect on. Number one here, the Lord clearly tells the apostles, no, they were not able to cure the boy because of their lack of faith, no? So I guess it highlights, no? It highlights the importance of faith in our work, especially in the ministry that we do, no? And this is the power of faith, no? And remember what constantly when people ask, how can they do this, how can they do that, when Gabriel would appear to them, always the usual response is, with God all things are possible, no? And that is, with God all things are possible, no? With faith, no? And again, you remember that, you know, that in the end, our own faith becomes channels of God's grace, no? As we pray for others, if we believe in God who will grant us the graces, no? But again, no, the power of faith is that with God all things are possible, no? And that in the many stories of healing in the gospel, no, you see how faith plays a very important role, no? It is our faith that allows God to work in, through, and with us, no? That first point to reflect on about faith, no? And then the second is, we become what we believe, no? For example, if you believe very sincerely and very deeply in Christ, no, we become more and more like Christ, no? We become Christ-like, no, in our life. And then also, even in a very purely psychological point of view, no, that's why it's important for us to be able to form, no, the image, the self-confidence, and that sense of security in young people, because they become what they believe in, no? That's why I think a very realistic awareness and knowledge of the self is important for us to develop in ourselves, and especially in the young people, no? Because they become what they believe in, no? I think if we believe that we are capable of good, that we are capable of service and loving, then we are able to live that out, no, in our lives. But if we don't have confidence in ourselves, and if we believe that we are good for nothing, then that will also happen. I've experienced that when I was a teacher before I became Jesuit, no? There was a class that I handled, and I was wondering why, no? The class had very little confidence, no? And it turns out that when they were in third year, I was handling them in fourth year, their teacher in third year kept on telling them that, you know, you guys should not be here, no? You don't have the brains to be in this school, no? And they believed in that. It becomes a self-fulfilling prophecy. So it's very important for us to really journey with others, especially the young, no? In what are the things that they will believe in? And it must be a faith that has a realistic knowledge of the self and a realistic knowledge even of the world and of God, no? So that they may really believe in the right things and believe in the graces that God has given them, no? We become what we believe, no? Then the third and last point is the importance of developing a very caring or supportive environment. As I mentioned in my example, no, this class who was certainly not given a caring environment by their third year teacher. In fact, on the contrary, no, they were pulled down by this, no. So I think it's important that this caring environment would have two things. Number one, the caring environment must allow them to have a realistic knowledge of themselves, no. Not to bloat their ego or not to put down their confidence, but just, you know, the right environment for them to discover and to become aware. And an environment that is very supportive of what they want to become. And now this is now the other element of that environment, to give them opportunities, no, to become the best of who they can become. So perhaps these are important elements, no, for people to have faith in themselves. Siguro mahalaga na pag nilaya natin itong ano, no, itong masasabi natin, isang napakahalagang paghubog sa atin at sa mga kasamahan natin, lalong-lalo ng kabataan, kung ano ang kanilang pinaniniwalaan, no? Sabi nga sa Ebanghelyo, di ba? Sabi nga dito, ang pananampalataya, ang pagtitiwala at pananampalataya ay mahalaga, no? Sapagkat ito'y merong kapangyarihan, ano? Sabi nga ng Ebanghelyo, di ba? Sa Diyos lahat ay posible. At 'yun ang kumbaga, 'yun ang sandigan ng ating pananampalataya, ang pagtitiwala sa Diyos, no? At 'yung pangalawang punto ay 'yun ngang kasabihan, di ba? At ito kitang-kita ko to sa aking mga trabaho, lalo-lalo na sa pagiging isang guro, na tayo ay nagiging kung sino ang ating pinaniniwalaan at na 'yung ating imahen, no? Sabi nga nila, 'yung self-fulfilling prophecy, no? Na pag naniwala tayong mabait tayo at may magagawa tayong mabuti at tama, na ano yan, nahuhubog sa atin yan at yun ang isinasabuhay natin. Kung tayo rin ay naniniwala na tayo ay wala tayong mabuting magagawa at maidudulot, yun din yung ating sinasabuhay. Ano? Kagaya nga nung ehemplo na binigay ko sa aking naturoang klase, no? Fourth year ko sila tinuruan, pero nung nasa third year high school sila, sinabihan sila ng isang teacher nila, no? Ang bobobo ninyo. Wala kayo dapat sa eskwelahan na ito, no? At naniwala 'yon, ano, natanim sa isipan nila at 'yun yung kanilang isinabuhay, ano? Dahil ito yung self-fulfilling prophecy, no? Na nagkakatotoo ko na yung ating pinaniniwalaan. Kaya mahalaga na magabayan natin, 'di ba? At mabigyan natin ng, at ito yung pangatlong punto, mabigyan natin ng isang lugar, isang espasyo, 'di ba, sa ating mga komunidad, sa ating mga pamilya, yung isang environment na mapagkalinga, na hinahayaan natin ng mga miyembro ng ating mga komunidad na madiskubre nila, no, ang ano ba ang kabutihan sa kanila, ano ang kanilang galing na pwede nilang isabuhay. At hindi lamang alaman, di ba, kundi pagkakataon din upang mahasa itong mga bagay na ito, no. Ito'y bahagi ng pagmasasabi natin, pagpapatatag ng kanilang paniniwala at pagtitiwala sa kanilang sarili. Today, let us pray, no, on this gift of faith. Again, hoping that we realize that, no, that in our own life, no, in a very deep sense, with God, all things are possible. And for us to believe, no, in the image and likeness that God has created in us and in the mission that He called us to, because we become what we believe in. And let us pray that we may develop and build caring environments where each and every one of us will become the best of who we can become. Let's pray for this as we continue our Mass. In prayer, we now approach God the Father, who has power and authority over all things.
That the Church and her people may be strengthened in their faith and rely on the Lord in trials and difficulties, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the hearts of world leaders may not be hardened and influenced by the evil of selfishness, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That hardened sinners may return to God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
As we honor the memory of the mother of your Son, we pray, O Lord, that the oblation of this sacrifice may, by your grace, make of us an eternal offering to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name in veneration of the Blessed Ever Virgin Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit she conceived her only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him and all the angels we praise your majesty. Dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you," Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now let us offer a prayer of humble faith and hope.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we humbly come before you in faith and hope. Grant us your grace and guidance as we emerge from this pandemic. We thank you for the blessings that saw us through the challenges of the past years. Reward those who selflessly serve and continue to serve our many needs. Console those who suffered. Heal the sick. Grant eternal rest to those who died. May we draw inspiration from our collective and individual experiences. Let our hearts burn within us to build a world closer to your kingdom of justice, truth, equality, peace, joy, faith, hope, compassion, and love. May each of us be a bright candle to remind us that light will overcome darkness and never the other way around. We pray for our nation. Give us the courage and inspiration to relentlessly take part in the project of building a nation that our founding fathers envisioned over a century ago, and to which succeeding generations offer their lives in dedicated service, some to the point of martyrdom. Heroes all, so Filipinos may continue to work for freedom and someday truly be free. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Lady of the Immaculate Conception, Patroness of the Philippines,
pray for us.
Our Lady, Help of all Christians and Health of the Sick,
pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Rock,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu,
have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy,
have mercy on us. And let us pray. Having been made partakers of eternal redemption, we pray, O Lord, that we who commemorate the Mother of your Son may glory in the fullness of your grace and experience its continued increase for our salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Again, maraming pong salamat. And again, please join us for Proyecto Pilipino, because we're going to talk about, as I mentioned the last two days, about the coming barangay elections. I think it's very important for us to take part in that, in the discussion, in the campaign, but most especially in the choosing of our barangay leaders, no? Very, very important to our democracy, no? And also, please join us, continue to join us in our journeys of hope this weekend. Maraming maraming pong salamat, and let's all pray and have a good weekend ahead. Thank you.
I can't feed 5,000, but I can feed one. I can't walk in water, but I can walk in the shoes of another. Sharing what I have in my hands is the miracle that needs to be seen today. This is what I can share. This is my Alay Kapwa. Alay Kapwa, a flagship program of Caritas Philippines by the Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines.